that the series isn't over, and we got a great opportunity, but we gotta take advantage.
How are you feeling? Are there nerves or butterflies, or is there a sense of calmness?
I just try to do the same things I've been doing every year, practice the shooting rounds, and approach the game the same way I've been doing it all season. Just try to be as calm as I can. I'm not going to lie, it's exciting to be a 3-0 in the finals. Any player would say that, but just knowing you got to, 48 minutes of focus and intensity in order for us to get to where we want to get to. And that's all you can ask for, coming into the year, 48 minutes to win a championship. We're looking forward to it.
I know you don't script reactions or plan them at all, but how do you hit this out of your life and then have no reaction?
I don't want to get too excited. I've plenty of times that I've made shots in my life and I've been too excited and the game didn't finish off the way I wanted to. So try to stay even keel, wait till the buzzer goes off for sure, to react to anything. Just try to finish the game off the best that I could.
So that wasn't your like whole Denzel walk off?
I was excited, no doubt, but I was more so happy that we had a nice Christmas team a few seconds ago. So that was awesome. But we knew we had to finish the game off before we could win.
In terms of those feelings of excitement being up 3-0, is that something that you got to kind of push down, suppress, and keep business like? And how does last year's experience of game 4, like you mentioned, up the top, help you do that?
One thing we're going to have to do is play with joy instead of happiness, if that makes sense. I think happiness is something that come and go so fast, so joy is something that's kind of that's in your DNA, so we want to play with that joy, but also play with a purpose and with energy and with a determined focus to win. Once we do that, then we'll put ourselves in a good position, if we start off the game thinking that way. We know what's at stake, and we know if we handle our business, we can celebrate and enjoy what we did, but for now, we got to approach the game as how we usually approach it as a team and as players individually, try to go out there and do our best to win.
At this moment, on the cusp of something like this, is it hard not to kind of be reflective and think about the journey that kind of took you guys here?
No, when you got an opportunity to, if you play good 48 minutes, we can do that after the game. So we want to come out here and just put all our focus and care and attention into the game and the game plan. How we come out on the road in a hostile environment and get a W. Those questions are better for after the game if we win. So we're looking forward to stepping out there and getting that opportunity to play.
You had last game, you had 3 threes up 34. And career, you
Yeah, I just felt like that was a good shot at the time I was open. I'm not looking to come out there and shoot from so deep. I just, felt like that was a good shot at the time, so glad it went in.
I know you analyzed game one, and you were like, I didn't play that well. So if you analyze game 3, do you say that's probably the best game you've played for the complete, all aspects of the game? Where does that rank for?
Oh, no. I don't know.
So if I say that, would I be wrong?
You can say whatever you want. That's why you are who you are. I kind of analyzed the game and seeing if I could build off it in a good way and see if I could have did something better. I felt like last game, I thought my intention was right, my intensity and focus was right. I didn't do everything perfect, but I felt like my energy was in the right place, and that's all I really wanted to play. Everything else falls in line after that, but as long as my energy and intensity is right, I can kind of make things go.
Last one.
Well, it's a family community when it comes to the Warriors. It's come as you are, be who you are, and I think everybody thrives in that environment, and it goes to show that the culture has been set, the foundation has been set. Now people that come on board are just starting to add to it, and I think that's what makes it a franchise that can sustain for so long. But we don't want to make decisions prematurely and bring everybody out and we're not finished the job. But I like forward thinking by the Warriors, but we got a job. We got a job.
I think they're coming out regardless.
I guess. But it just shows how tight we are as a group, everybody, from players to executives to front office to everybody that has a hand in what the Warriors do. And, I think it all just stems from the top. Coaching that they set. Everybody comes in with a standard. They got to uphold, not just for players, everybody. So you see it through moves like this.
Great, thank you.